Yeah, we did it already.
The first one we did, all right. So this is now, guys, whatever you say, how silly it is, it will be recorded for all time, so be careful.
Is Colton joining us or not?
I don't know if he is or not. If he does, I will let him in. If he's not, I think I can just post it. I don't know how.
He hasn't been joining anything.
Yeah, he's been just a delinquent.
He's gonna listen to this. Don't talk bad about him. He's gonna
listen. All right. Biden's basement going.
So we talked about how if we send this off just horizontal, it's going to go this direction, and the whole time it's in the air, even though it's going to fall in the horizontal direction, we're going to say that no change will occur, that Vx.
Should we draw this? Or like?
Not yet. No, the stuff that I'm going to put will be on here. So the Vx, okay, it's big family now, is always going to stay the same until it hits the ground. The velocity in the x direction, the velocity of the projectile will change because it's going to speed up as it goes down. Up here, as it's coming, it's going to have a Vy. Nice.
Ooh, look at that.
Ooh.
Okay. Technology these days.
As it moves down. Oh, but I should have done that.
He's like, oh.
I have an infinite cloner there, so I can. Whoops. There we go. It's going to start keep getting longer. The x stays exactly the same. According to gravity, as gravity picks up, it's going to accelerate going down. So it's not going to drop very much in the first tenth of a second. In the fourth tenth of a second, same time, it's going to drop a lot more because it's going to have a lot more Vy as it goes through. We're going to do these, and this is the vectors part of it.
Vectors.
The vectors.
Yeah.
We're going to divide it into the two components. Every vector can be taken apart into its component parts. We're going to do the x and the y separately. So
velocity is always the same going down, you said?
No.
Oh, it's all hits the
in
ground.
The X.
It's always the same. It's
always the same. Okay. Unchanged. So we can use, we're going to use this same D equals V1T plus 1/2 AT squared.
Did I go? It's on there, sort of.
All right. We're going to use that, but we're going to change this for X and for Y. So for the X, we're going to get, because there is no acceleration in the X direction. In the X direction, as long as it is sent, well, no matter how it's sent, in the X direction, we're going to say there is no acceleration. That can speed up, not going to slow down. Air resistance, not a thing we're going to worry about. So this part of it will go away. So we're going to have D in the X direction is equal to, there is no V1 or V2 because there's no acceleration. It's just V will equal the velocity in the x direction times time. Okay, so that's work. Okay, so this is one equation, and this is going to go under the title of horizontal. If something is fired at horizontal, we're going to use two equations. This is the first one that we're going to use. The next one we're going to do in the y direction.
And that's for x.
This is the x direction, yes. We're going to use this, so we're going to get dy, but v1, when we shoot it off exactly this way, and Max told us on Thursday, I don't know if he remembers, earlier, what is the velocity in the y direction when we first shoot it off this way?
Zero.
Zero, because it's not going up or down. Everything is x. All we have is vx. So if this is zero, we aren't going to worry about it at all. So dy is going to equal 1 half of a. What is the acceleration due to gravity? 9.80. So we're going to take half of that. No, you don't have to do that. 4.9.
Oops.
4.9 t squared. On your formula list, make a little box. Horizontal, anytime something is fired horizontally, have a little section here where those are the only two equations you're going to need. Isn't that fun? That's easy. That's how this is going to be.
Please be me. Please.
Whoa. Y'all are excited.
Teach it here.
I don't know.
Hey, I'm watching.
Hello?
Hello.
Important. You'll either come see me or call back. So the dy equals 4.9 t squared is the y. Well, yeah. How are they both horizontal? If one
is they're not. No, this is for the questions that says if something like is shot horizontally. So for example,
so we're trying to find y horizontally, that's the equation we use, right?
Yeah, and then, well, okay, so this is, go ahead, turn to the next page. We started this one. This question written out would say if a ball is hit with a horizontally with a velocity of 36 meters per second from the top of a 32 meter building, how far from the edge of the building will it land? So it was shot horizontally. So you know, hey, horizontally, I've got a little box on my formula list. I'm of course, formula list is in my sack, and I forgot my sack, so we're in trouble. But
so would it be using...
wait? Oh. Let me go through how to do this. We did the first part, and we talked about this last time. In any of these, the first thing, find time.
Wow.
We want to find time. Now, you're always going to be given enough that we can find time, but we're not, it'll be different depending on what they've told us. Now, if we look at, here's our two equations. Dx equals Vx t and dy equals 4.9 t squared. We want t, so we have to either know dx and Vx, or we need to know dy.
We know dy.
Do we know dx and Vx?
No.
No, we're actually looking for dx. We do know Vx, but we don't. So we just pick the one that we can solve for time. Because we need time. Time is in both of them.
So
I'm going to use this one. So dy,
32
equals 4.9 t squared.
Whoa.
So t squared equals 32 divided by 4.9. And I think you did that for us last time. Did somebody?
Wait.
Maybe. Uh-oh. I don't remember. It might have been Max. And he's...
Hold on. 6.5306122.
C equals what?
Just 6.53. Or there's two, so 6. Point...
I don't get that. Did you square root it?
You don't have to divide it before you square root it.
You do.
Okay. So you don't square root
32 divided by 4.9. And well, then square
that gets you 6.53. We have to square root that.
Yeah.
So
2.55555555. 2.55555555. I remember that from Thursday. So I'm gonna take a bunch of extra seconds. All right. So we found the time. Now we want to know dx. Well, luckily, look at here. We've got a simple little formula
here. We got an equation.
So dx,
I love vectors,
equals vx, which we know.
It's the profile of
36 meters per second times. Seconds, our seconds are going to cancel. We take 36 times 2.556.
Wait, why?
Because dx equals vxt.
We know t. Okay, sorry.
Is.
Good.
Anyone?
Hold on. 92.016.
92.016. I actually only get two significant digits, so
92.
DX equals 92 meters. That's a long ways. Tall building, hit pretty hard. Pretty simple. The first thing you do every time is what, JC?
You're going to find time.
Yeah.
Because there's
find time. If you can't find time, then you check the schedule, see if anything else is off for fifth hour.
So that means that's how time.
You can always find time.
So does that mean how many meters it is until it hits the ground?
That's how far dx is, how far this direction it goes.
So it goes 92 meters off the building straight.
Yes.
Jeez, but that's a long time. That's a long way.
But it's a very tall building going very fast. So it's going to be like this. There's no just triangle with it. It's going like that, but it's going to be 92 meters out here, and the horn on that car will start going off. Yep. All right. So, yes. Yes.
Good job.
Try the next one, and you can work cooperatively, work with the person that's sitting next to you.
What if you both know dx and dy? Can you just use both?
Then life is good for you. Whoops. I bet there's this is.
Oh, dy because you don't know dx. Joe, you are smart.
She's a genius.
Genius.
Oh, we do not talk about that.
I know.
I'm still mad about that.
Wait, why?
All right.
I just stopped going on.
Max, what'd you do? Max didn't do it. This time.
No, it wasn't.
People getting involved.
Is
it a no? It's the other one's best friend.
Oh.
I
got
2.25. Your battery is low. Don't care. Watch it just die on you.
That's the time, and then you have to find running DX. So.
He really puts a charge into this one.
Mr. Schmidt, so once you have time, you're trying to find VX, and you do DX equals VXT, right?
You know DX, and you know T now. It's given to you.
No way.
It was just, it wasn't there, and I just came over here and snapped my fingers, and there it was.
Mr. Schmidt, I'm getting it.
The nice part about this is you can understand this. We're going to do a little bit of practice.
How many sig figs do you get?
What do you have? You got two here, two there. I would take two.
Easy.
Yeah, yeah.
Three?
Two?
Let's go.
Are you trying to punch her?
I was like,
salute the genius.
The Did you? No, we did it together, Mr. Schmidt.
All right.
What'd you guys get?
We're not right there yet.
Well, you see, what happened was.
Look at all that. Look at all that brain.
They're not genius.
That doesn't mean we're not genius.
Oh,
I know.
Okay.
You guys are all, we're all geniuses in God's eyes.
Come Wednesday, you are actually going to do target practice, and you are going to figure this out.
All right, Mr. Schmidt, you think we're ready for that yet?
I do. Well, not yet, but you will on Wednesday. And you're going to put the car where you think, and you're going to try and hit that. And you have to hit it the first time. Points? All the points? None of the points.
Amen.
There you go.
Looks like all pressure in and out on Wednesday.
With. How much? You only get 2 6 figs.
53.
Put a unit on it.
Meters.
There you go.
She would say amen to that, Mr. Schmidt.
No. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Oh, I've got to move these up.
Another one.
Another one.
Mr. Schmidt, can I show this paper apart? Like Taylor Staples out?
Sure. It's yours.
Are you ready?
Time to go.
All right, recording.
Wait,
everything is on there. I'm gonna
wait, Mr. Schmidt.
I'm waiting. I'm waiting.
Whoa, whoa.
Yes.
Why is the V not DX? Oh, there's no DX. Okay. So we are finding the deep Y.
All right.
Let's find time, shall we? So.
Are you a number?
Oh, it's a tall building.
Holy cow.
Especially when you only have 2 6 weeks.
Honestly, neither do I. You literally know what you're doing.
Oh, no.
It's
fun.
AC is a genius.
Actually, it's kind of fun. Oh, Jiyoung, did you get? Hard.
Oh, I see where you got that.
Did you get that?
Yeah,
what? You didn't square it.
180 meters.
Just take your answer times six.
I told you I'm a genius.
Genius.
It's just me. I told you I was a genius.
Boom.
Boom.
I told you I was a genius. Wait.
Genius.
I got
JC.
Okay. DX equals my own. I'm on there.
Yes.
Equals DXC. So 150 equals 25T.
Why is this easier than
gives
anything?
Gives me T equals 6. DY equals 4.9 T squared. Miss Ju-Young, squared equals 4.9 times 6 squared equals 176.2.
You made her feel bad.
4.
She just had to rub it in.
Oh, 180 meters tall, very tall. Whoa. Building. Be careful at the edge. And now the fun really begins.
Oh,
got it on the book.
Oh,
hopefully you have a genius friend.
You shouldn't help him.
Oh,
why?
Whoa.
What did I do?
All right, and
I helped her.
Genius helped.
For those playing along at home, there you go. And look at that last one, a bonus. And I believe, if I remember correctly, the bonus has a literary theme.
A literary theme. He's like, literary theme.
Let's be careful with Jeopardy.
Hey,
oh.
Well, I know what I'm doing. I know what I'm doing in study hall tomorrow.
Wait, who's gonna take over?
I don't know. He was Canadian. Pancreatic cancer.
Yeah, okay.
All right.
Did you that?
All right, Jesus.
What are you guys talking about?
Trebek.
You know that Mr. Wells passed away?
Yeah. All right.
She's even willing to share her book with me.
I know. I heard. Well, Colton, there you go. Watch that, and you're good to go.